action is underway here at the 29th Summer Universiade in Taipei. You're looking at the Fujian University Stadium, one of the many sites for football. We'll get going with some women's action on August 18th, just the day before the opening ceremonies begin here at Taipei. Here we see some of the crowd on hand, and this will be Chinese Taipei taking on Argentina. This is women's Group A action. The players enter the pitch following the FISU flag. Here you see Chinese Taipei in blue on the left, and Argentina in their traditional light blue and white. There are the referees and assistants for this match, and the starting lineup for Chinese Taipei. Head coach is Nagira Masayuki. We're just about ready to get going. There's the Argentinian starting lineup. Head coach Rosana Gomez. And there you see Masayuki. Football action is underway at Universiade. And there you see Gomez, the head coach of the Argentinian side. In the third minute, Argentina with the free kick. Chinese Taipei able to clear it away. And back here is Agustina Pesani. Use it for keeper Garton. Pesani again for the turnover. Right onto the foot of Chen Yanping. Still put it past Gabriela Garton for the first goal of this tournament. A poor giveaway there by Pesani. And Chinese Taipei takes advantage. And they're up 1-0. There you see that right-footed pass. Stolen away by Chen. Head up all the way. Uses that right foot to put it past the Argentinian keeper. Now a little bit later into the first half. Argentina thinking it's offside, and Chen again. A nice play defensively there by Pesani. Able to knock it out of bounds. Now here's Florencia Sanger. She'll put a ball into the box. Just headed right at goal, but a wonderful save by Chu Fang Yi. Now here's Lee for Chinese Taipei. A nice little cue ball there, but Chen just cannot quite catch up to it. Couldn't get that left foot on it. And as we head into halftime, it remains 1-0 on that goal by Chen in the third minute. There you see Chen, goal scored, almost had that second one. Chinese Taipei again with control. Argentina knocks that one out of bounds. Garton and Lee with the header to put Chinese Taipei up 2-0. Garton seemed a bit distracted by Yu right in front of her. You'll see it right there. The ball skips past her and Lee right on the spot with the header. 2-0 Chinese Taipei. Right inside the bar with the left foot. Chinese Taipei up 3-0. Another calculated strike there by Chen. Her second goal of the match. We'll get a great look at it right here with that left foot. Right inside the bar. No chance for Gartone. And Chinese Taipei with a commanding 3-0 lead. Argentina would not give up though. Here's Urbani with the cross. And that one threw it well out of bounds. Now in injury time here in the second half, Chinese Taipei will clear, and that will be it. The opening match of Universiad goes to the host country, Chinese Taipei, 3-0 victory over Argentina. Summary there, Chen with 2 goals. Now the evening on August 18th, Fujian University Stadium again. This is Mexico taking on Chinese Taipei in men's Group A action. Here you have the officials for this match. Mexico with their pregame photo, wearing their traditional green, and Chinese Taipei in blue. And there you see the starting lineup for Chinese Taipei. Head coach Li Wen Tsai. And there's the starting lineup for Mexico. Head coach Diego Lopez Aguiar. There you see Li, the head coach for Chinese Taipei, and Lopez Aguiar, the aforementioned head coach of Mexico. Free kick here for Mexico in the early games of the first half. And a beautiful little header there. Patricio Trevino. We'll get a good look at it here. Just a little bit of a touch there off the free kick, and the captain puts Mexico up 1-0. Now we are late in the first half. We are in injury time. Taipei coming out one last attempt. They'll get it, but that shot fired wide by Chen. That would have equalized it heading into halftime. But as it stands, Mexico heads into the half up 1-0. Again, that cross headed away by Chinese Taipei. You'll see great work here, great pressure by Mexico. And finally, the ball does get turned over. It's Manuel Garduno. And just outside the box, he fires one into the top corner. Great effort initially to regain possession of the ball. And then a beautiful strike to the upper right corner of the net, right in behind Huang. And Mexico builds on its lead. There you see it, Huang, no chance on that beautiful strike just outside the 18-yard box. Coming right at you here. Mexico excited with this 2-0 lead. Now Chen with the free kick. That one deflects off the bar and out. Another great chance there for Chen and Chinese Taipei. Mexico avoids danger, gets the ball ultimately out of bounds. Now, in the 80th minute, a turnover there, but regained by Chinese Taipei. Another turnover, now Mexico with a chance. It is Quiñones, and he'll curl one inside the bar. 3-0 Mexico, and he tops it off with the cartwheel and the flip. And you'll see it here, just a perfect ball right inside the post. And Quiñones, after a couple Chinese Taipei turnovers, puts the Mexicans up 3-0 in the 80th minute. And that will do it. Mexico with a commanding performance against the host Chinese Taipei. They win 3-0. Trevino, Garduno, and Quiñones with the 3 goals for the Mexicans. Taipei will have to wait to look for their first victory here at Taipei's Universiade. Mexico, big win over Chinese Taipei here in Taipei. Fujian Catholic University Stadium, another site for football here at Universiade. Japan and Malaysia here on opening ceremony day at this 29th Summer Universiade. Japan in the dark uniforms and Malaysia in the black and yellow. And Japan gets going early. That ball off the bar, but fired home there by Hatate. Tashima had the initial pass into Nakano. His shot went off the bar. But as it came out, Hatate fired it past a couple Malaysian defenders to give Japan the 1-0 advantage. Here you see that one off the bar. And then Hatate just fires it home. Off the corner for Japan. And that one is turned around and rifled in behind Samsudin. And that is Hatate again, his second goal of the match. And there you see Japanese head coach Junichi Miyazaki. He's pretty pleased with how Hatate has performed here in the first half, putting Japan up 2-0. And that will end the opening 45 minutes with Japan maintaining that two-goal advantage. Now into the second half, Japan on the attack again. An opportunity here, but fired over the bar by Sachiro Toshima. That might have put this match out of distance for Malaysia. And now the Malaysians with a chance here in the 64th minute. Asnan Ahmad with a chance, but that one fired wide. Now a little later in the second half, off the corner. There's a beautiful bicycle kick by Nakano off the bar, and Malaysia ultimately able to clear. Get a good look at that one right here. Beautiful play there by Nakano. He can't believe it didn't go in. But Malaysia able to survive that. Another chance here for the Japanese in stoppage time in the second half. But ultimately, the referee will blow it down after that final attempt. And Japan wins its opening match here against Malaysia 2-0 on two goals from Reo Hatate. Malaysia falls to 0-1. There you get a great look at the Nangang Exhibition Center here in Taipei, the site for artistic gymnastics at these 29th World University Games. It is the men's all-around qualification round, as gymnastics competition gets underway just before the opening ceremonies. First up, we'll take a look at Fabian De Luna of Mexico. He will perform on the rings. De Luna was born in the United States, but competes for Mexico. Attends the University of the Pedregal. You can admire just the strength and balance that these athletes have to maintain in all disciplines, and certainly here on the rings, and De Luna putting in a strong performance here. competed at the 2015 World Championships in Glasgow, Scotland. And on the dismount, just holds it there. A nice performance for DeLuna. He would score 14.550 to hold the best score in the rings in the early goings in qualification. And there you see him just stick that dismount. And now we move on to Marios Georgiou of Cyprus. If you take a look on the back of his neck, tattooed there are the Olympic rings, and he was the lone Cypriot gymnast at last year's Rio Olympics. And now competing here in Taipei at Universiad. Here on the parallel bars, Georgiou attends the University of Nicosia in Nicosia. Put up a score of 14.100 on the high bar earlier here in qualification. There's his dismount, a little bit of a hop, but a good solid performance here for Georgiou. He would score 80.150 overall, putting him second in qualification in the early goings. You get some close up there of his work on the parallel bars. And there you see that score of 14.050. Now we move on to Tomas Kuzmikas of Lithuania. This is his floor routine. His other high score here in qualification, 13.975 on the parallel bars. He's also 13.950 on the vault. So a good performance so far here for Kuzmikas, looking to build on that here on the floor. He attends the Lithuanian Sports University in Kaunas. Now you get a look at the flexibility of these athletes and the strength here on the handstand. And one final pass here for the Lithuanian. And a solid performance for him on the floor, 14.150. And a very consistent overall performance here in qualification, as Kuzmikas leads in the early stages with an overall score of 82.075.